Good afternoon. I would like to welcome you all to the second annual Alan McGill Symposium on Malaria Elimination and Eradication. I'd like to also pass on my special thanks to the Society for their ongoing support of this symposium and a chance to both celebrate Alan's contributions and his commitment to a world free of malaria. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Scott Miller. I serve as the Deputy Director on the Malaria Team at the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, overseeing our research and development investments, both to maintain the gains of the past 15 years, as well as to accelerate and develop new tools towards achieving malaria elimination. I've had the privilege to work with Alan for on and off over the 15 years before I joined the foundation 2 years ago, and had the specific privilege to have him serve as both my mentor and at times my boss over our joint careers in the U.S. Army. And I guess in a sad way, I'm also the last addition to the malaria team at the Gates Foundation prior to his untimely passing. As I reflected on some opening comments on this event, I was drawn to Paul Farmer's comments last night at the opening address, specifically regarding equity in tropical medicine, as he put it. Because this is the year, 10 years ago, at a foundation event on malaria, where Melinda Gates openly called for malaria elimination. And for those of you who may have seen those comments in the past, but just to reiterate them, she said, any goal short of eradicating malaria is accepting malaria. It's making peace with malaria. It's rich countries saying, we don't need to eradicate malaria as long as we've eliminated in our own countries. And that's just not acceptable. So in that spirit of equity, I think that's what really inspired Alan when he joined the foundation and working upon efforts from the malaria team and many of you in the audience, he outlined a framework for malaria elimination and proceeded to launch a series of operational research studies that those of us at the foundation are very proudly to be seeing presented really throughout this meeting, as well as still some ongoing work. And the goals of those were to test the hypothesis of that elimination framework. Much of that work is still playing itself out, as I mentioned. But I know that having worked with Alan over those 15 years, he would be proud of the efforts that have been made to generate the data to both test and to reform the hypotheses on how to best accelerate elimination. For this year's symposium, Gina and I thought that we would start with an update on the country's progress towards the 2020 elimination goals, and then focus on some of the key challenges and the gaps that were evident in early on in the preparation of that elimination framework, namely the challenge of residual transmission, the gaps of special populations, specifically women of childbearing age, and the challenge of relapsing malaria. So thank you all again for attending today, and I'll turn it over to Gina.